We are still into the topic of the integral of the powers of sine and cosine functions. In this lesson, we will focus on functions of this form. Okay? It's a product of sine and cosine functions, and each of them, or one of them is raised to an odd positive integer exponent. So these are the tools that might be helpful when we are working with functions such as this. We know that the derivative of sine is cosine, and the derivative of cosine is negative sine of x. The technique of substitution might also be helpful, okay? So if we choose one function to be u, okay? If we let u be equal to f of x, then du is equal to f prime of x dx. The Pythagorean identity will also or might also be very helpful. So with the power reduction formula and also with your power rule. So let us begin with something simple. Let us get the antiderivative of the cube of sine of x cosine of x dx. So we know that the derivative of sine is cosine. And so the technique of substitution is the right choice of technique to get the antiderivative. Let u be equal to sine of x, du is cosine of x dx. So we can write this function in this way. This is the cube of u, and then this whole thing is just du. We apply the power rule. And so our antiderivative is this, 1/4 times sine of x raised to 4 plus c. Now let us say this is our function. Get the antiderivative of the cube of sine of x times the cube of cosine of x dx. So this is what you do. You factor out one cosine. And of course, when you factor out one cosine, you will be left. What is left is the square of cosine of x. And then we will use your Pythagorean identity for the square of cosine of x. So this becomes this. Okay, so this is just factoring out one cosine of x from the cube of cosine of x. We will use your Pythagorean identity for the cosine of, or for the square of cosine of x. And then we will do the multiplication, okay? This will bring you to this function. And so you know that the derivative of sine of x is cosine of x. And so the technique of substitution will help you here, okay? So let u be equal to sine of x, du is cosine of x. And so our function becomes a function that is polynomial in form. And you know how to get the antiderivative. You will just use your power rule. Okay. And so the antiderivative is this. 1/4 times sine of x raised to 4 minus 1/6 times sine of x raised to 6 plus c. Obtain the antiderivative. We can use the same solution, okay? We can factor out one cosine from this expression, okay? And then repeat what we did in the previous example. We can do that. And in fact, that should be the easier route to solve this problem. But let us take the more difficult path. We will factor out one sine of x from this function. Okay, so factor out one sine of x from this function and you will be left with sine of x raised to 4. Okay, and sine of x raised to 4 is just this. And the reason why I chose to write it in this way is because I want you to see where the Pythagorean identity will come in. The Pythagorean identity will come in here. Okay. So the square of sine of x is just 1 minus the square of cosine of x. So I just rearranged our function. So I will expand this binomial. I will do the multiplication. Okay, you can verify this yourself. Okay, so pay attention to the laws of exponents, and this will be the result. And so this one is something that can be solved using your technique of substitution. Let u be equal to cosine of x. Du is negative sine of x. Okay, so be careful. So sometimes this is confusing. Okay, so the derivative of cosine of x is not just sine of x. It's negative sine of x. So this means that sine of x dx is negative du. Okay, so let us write everything in terms of u. So this one is a function that is polynomial in form. We can integrate this term by term, apply your power rule, and this is the result. So I will bring us back to the earlier slide, okay? So when you have functions such as this, wherein n and m are positive integer exponents, and one of them is an odd exponent, then these are the things that you can use. You may have to use all of them. Or maybe you will use one, two, or three of them. And so these are the tools that are helpful when you are working with functions such as this. Remember that the derivative of sine is cosine. The derivative of cosine is negative sine of x. Usually, the technique of substitution is very helpful when you are working with functions such as this. And also remember your Pythagorean identity. Now, in the examples that I did today, I was not able to use this power reduction formula. But maybe this power reduction formula will help us when we are working with functions when both n and m are even integers. And of course, the power rule.